item number four, county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, these are actually four and five are linked, and these are items that I had brought to a previous work session asking the board to ratify both an amendment to a previous intergovernmental agreement that the county had been a party to and has been unilaterally amended between the school board and the sheriff's office. And then number five, which is another agreement which we were never a party to, which is for the lease of some land at Chesty Elementary School by the sheriff's office for a mounted patrol stables which have been built. So we talked about this at the prior work session, and I wanted to bring it back to you. Item number four is the first one. You know, back in September of 2010, we basically executed a tripartite agreement involving Board of Education, the sheriff's office, and the county, involving some school resource officers. The sheriff agreed to provide five of them to the Board of Education. And the funding mechanism, by the way, is in that agreement. I think that the Board of Education basically picked up a tab for roughly 70% of those positions. The amendment that is the first document in the agenda packet provides for two additional school resource officers between the sheriff's office and the Board of Education. One position to be funded by the Board of Education, and then the sheriff's office will fund the second position. But the one funded by the second, or by the school, excuse me, by the sheriff, the SRO funded by the sheriff, is linked to the IGA that's agenda item number five, which is the lease agreement. So it's difficult to talk about one and not both agreements. The last time we discussed four and five, and I'm mixing four and five, Mr. Chairman, so just forgive me on that. It's hard to discuss one of them in a vacuum. The last time we discussed four and five, the board had some specific questions. First question you had pertained to the lease agreement, that is the ability of the sheriff's office to erect this mounted patrol facility at Chesty Elementary School. The first question was, is it complete? The answer is yes, it is complete. The next question was, how much did it cost? The information I have back is that it cost around $57,000, $50,000 for the structure, and it looks to me like $7,000 for labor. Bob Shaw indicated that most of the labor was provided by the SO staff or officers, so it doesn't look like there was an intensive labor cost, but there was some. The next question was it permitted in CO? The answer was yes, that it was, and that it was CO'd in August of this year. And so that's what I've got. I brought these two agreements to you, quite frankly, because the Board of Commissioners needs to ratify them. The first one, the short one, the amendment, is part of a contract that we were an original signatory on. So we need to amend a contract in which we were a party to it. You just can't, two parties can't just go and amend an agreement that three had to consummate in the beginning. So we need to ratify that one. Of course, the amendment is for the additional two SROs, which will mean that there will be a total of seven SROs at the Board of Education facilities.
I have one question, please.
Yes.
What is the value of the SRO, and is it being equally swapped the amount of the lease by the year or by the 14-month lease?
The way I read the agreement is that the Board of Education is fully funding one, mm-hmm. and that the sheriff is basically being compensated for the other by way of the lease agreement.
So that's approximately $44,000? Is that what our SRO officers are running?
I don't know. I don't know the exact cost. That sounds close.
That's what I think was brought up at last meeting. Is that, I mean, how much land is that to lease for that kind of money? And that's an annual basis, or?
It is annual, and of course, when I talked to the sheriff, you know, one of the concerns you all had raised was in the lease agreement, the ability for either party to terminate for 60 days advance notice. And of course, the sheriff quite appropriately commented, well, if they terminate the lease agreement, then obviously they've lost some of the SROs because they're lame. So I don't think they'll do that. And I'm not terribly concerned between two governments that are part of the Forsyth County umbrella of government, then this really becoming a litigation matter as much as I think it is just a practical issue.
Yeah, I'm just trying to see the value of the land and what we're giving. If the true value of that officer is $44,000, how many acres is it that's included in the lease?
You know, the actual amount of land is not identified in the lease agreement. This was something that was presented to me, not drafted by me, and it's not included.
Is it normal for a sheriff to be able to sign an intergovernmental agreement without the Board of Commissioners?
There is no question that sheriffs have the unilateral ability to enter into agreements as part of their governmental functions. Because this one contains indemnity language that provides that the sheriff will indemnify if, for instance, a third party trips and falls on the lease premises, I have to bring it to you because at the end of the day, the only entity responsible for indemnifying will be us. It'll be our insurance coverage that would provide that indemnity, so I wanted to make sure that we approved.
$3,600, $66.66 a month for just land lease. And I don't think it's more than, what, 5 or 6 acres?
So you need action at this time, Council?
Well, we'll just start with agenda item number 4. That is an amendment to an agreement of which you're a party. You need to approve it if you want to approve it. If you don't want to approve it,
what kind of a number would be reasonable?
I don't know. I have to do the market analysis. I always would be guessing, but I mean, full size 10,000 square warehouse is right for that. On commercial land. But I don't think we have a say so in the deal that he makes, do we? I mean,
You do. You do on both. That's the tough part about this, is that the amendment, again, is part of a tripartite agreement of which you're a party. So until you ratify it, I'm not sure that it's actually a true amendment yet.
But it's something that sheriff has already entered into and obviously been doing it for
the performance year. Has already commenced. Yes.
Yeah, performance has already
commenced. So. Performance has commenced. Now tell me this, what do you know about the agreement or the use of the polo fields facility they had done for years and years and years? And is that, I'm hearing a rumor that's still in effect, and why aren't we there for free?
I know very little about that. I know the party that was with, and I understand that, I'm not going to name names, but I understand the party that agreement was with was attempting to sort of use that agreement as a means to secure some other concessions, all legal, by the way, but some other concessions, and the sheriff walked away from it.
I mean, if we ratify this, it's almost like we're agreeing at this price.
Yeah, it's the sheriff's budget, which we can look at next month.
Well, you know, I voted against that.
Well, that's true. It did pass, though.
And it did pass. Well, you're going to vote however you want, I guess.
So the amendment.
Yes, sir.
We have to agree to provide for the indemnity.
No, not on this one. Let me be very clear. The one that, agenda item number four, is an amendment to an existing IGA of which Forsyth County is a part of.
That's one we got to do.
You have to be a party to this one for it to be a valid agreement, because two parties can't modify a three-party agreement.
But this one talks about the amendment is the funding for that seventh SRO.
For the two. The school, as I read this amendment, the school board funds one, and then the sheriff funds the other, but the funding of that other one is by way of the IGA.
Well,
Does this have an ending to it, Ken? Does this date it?
The ending of this one would be subject to the original one we adopted back in September of 2010. That agreement terminates on June 30th of 2013.
That's when we should look at it really bad. If we don't agree,
18 months.
We don't agree with it, we basically take an officer out of school right now, don't we?
Can't do that.
You know, if you don't agree with it, I would just have to provide that information to the sheriff and the Board of Education, and they would have to take whatever response.
Well, they can enter into a side agreement instead of amending an agreement. Why can't they enter into a new agreement for two officers?
They could.
And exclude us altogether.
Yeah, but my only problem is the amount of lease of that land. I mean, certainly I don't want to take the officer out of school.
But if they.
The agreement.
But we got to approve item five for us being dipped, for us to be on insurance, don't we?
If we want to do that.
Well, that's my position.
I mean, if we don't provide the insurance, then somebody's got to come up with insurance for it.
Well, that would be real challenging, because that's not, the sheriff's office doesn't really provide it.
That's it. I mean, it's basically tell them not to use land.
Could we ask the sheriff, what would your recommendation be about asking the sheriff to not have an amendment to the tripartite agreement, but enter into a separate agreement? He's a constitutional officer and can do that. To provide two officers, they compensate for one and he barters the other.
I think that his position about speaking to him would be, the result would be the same. I would be committing an additional officer or two that I will come to you asking you to fund by way of my budget, which is exactly the position.
I think Mr. Levin has a point that by agreeing to this, we're basically agreeing that we're going to pay $3,600 a month for a pasture.
Small pasture.
And that's, you know, I know that, you know, in the end, it's still taxpayer money, but, you know, I know that the sheriff has the ability to do what he wants with his budget.
Look, before this got built, the horse had to be kept somewhere. What were the costs for that? And there was no cost for that?
Well, the individual, I think, passed that the agreement was with, but I also understand, I don't have it in writing, but I understand that in the will, it still was going to allow the sheriff there, but you're saying some other things got convoluted, mixed up in there, and the sheriff didn't, walked away trying to find another place.
You mean somebody passed away and there's an error that's now controlling it or something?
Yes.
I guess.
But we don't know of any true of cost to the county, so it's not like.
Wasn't there? Was no cost to the county back then. It was free. But the deal for this land is just astronomical to me. I just don't see how that.
It's just about. What is it? Let me go on 18 months, you said? Then we won't let him do any more agreements without coming to us first.
Well, the fact of the matter is, I don't think he cares if we tie him into.
That's correct.
He obviously just doesn't.
Well, next time we can.
Or will we do the same thing we do now and say, well, next time we'll address it? And who knows who's going to be on the board at that point? But
it's always that way.
Yeah, we're going to punish the school. The same taxpayer money. I mean, we're going to make the school pay for it.
I don't know if that's a.
It's same taxpayer money, but it comes to different avenues, and we're responsible for this. So.
Is there any school now that doesn't have an SRO?
Is there anybody here from the school system?
Wait,
actually.
Don't do that to me.
Okay. The original IGA provides that the five SROs originally envisioned would be at West Forsyth, South Forsyth, Central, Lambert, and North Forsyth. So that's where your five are. The additional two.
They were at the high schools.
Yeah.
And they also covered the middle schools that were nearby, I believe.
So there's no way we can continue all of these seven officers without.
Well, I think all the high schools have.
Getting caught up in this deal with his.
The
sheriff's in negotiation.
No, there might be. I mean, I could certainly go back to the sheriff and ask that they, you know, rescind or withdraw this agreement and enter into their own IGA that doesn't work as an amendment to the original SRO. But understand, that's still going to have the sheriff binding himself to commit these SROs, to which you will see again in your budget when he submits his budget. So you'll be
able to go back. We're going to have to see this SRO come up.
I just hate to be a part of this agreement.
Well, maybe you just make the displeasure and move on. Wish, you know, it's not something that we agreed to.
Is there a motion?
What if we realize it's a little late? Can we postpone this to give it some more consideration?
Given that it's built and implemented, I'm not sure of the urgency at this point.
I mean, yeah.
Thank you for that, exactly. I mean, really.
I mean, instead, it makes just we can delay it. It's just going to keep going.
Well, the only thing that concerns me is if there was truly a claim out there. That's my biggest concern.
Couldn't the school system provide the insurance? I mean, couldn't it be covered on their liability policy?
Well, but that's the whole thing. They want the tenant, if you will, to indemnify them, not a common requirement.
Well,
Who's been doing it for the last almost 2 years?
Doing what?
Insurance. Who's been responsible? Nobody?
Well, that would, if a claim arose, we would go to our insurance carrier and they might bond and provide indemnity since we never approved the agreement.
Yeah, they just built the barn this summer.
When you think the $3,600 a month, they bought that insurance?
Boy. You think they provide a lot of things for them?
How about feed?
Feed?
Yeah. That's the next thing. What does it cost to house two horses somewhere for feed and insurance?
Understand, and I'm not suggesting to you, I see a rash of mounted control claims coming down the pipe. I'm just trying to look at the practical. If it does occur, which is the worst case scenario, and we hadn't approved the indemnity, I think you might be the first to say, why are we responsible for these kids if they never approved it?
The other side of it to consider is it also leaves us exposed.
Yes, it does.
Until we accept it, it leaves us exposed.
Well, some kid walks in the barn and a horse kicks him.
Yeah. Then we're basically uncovered.
We're going to waste a lot more than $44,000.
Yeah,
well,
based on that.
Well, that's true, but the other consideration here is, and I don't know how much the sheriff or the school board ought to have known, but the way I see the dates on there, somebody other than this board has caused an exposure to the county for 5 or 6 months here, which is not a good thing.
No, that's the original. We're talking about the 5 months that they've been in operation. And,
yeah,
and I guess we need to put, if you would, again, I think it'd be, I think that as much as we're probably not comfortable with it, we need to approve these so we don't have that exposure. But I think you also ought to put the school system and sheriff's office on notice that the board won't accept these agreements in the future.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think that's appropriate?
We need to
just put them on notice.
We need to forewarn that this won't happen again.
Yeah. It's almost like they did all this and then knowing we wouldn't have a choice but to vote for it.
Well, you know that, and I want to be very clear. The reason that this came to you is because the finance director brought it to me. They had an issue about how to put this on their own books, and quite frankly, I thought did a good job of alerting me to it, and my first option is going to be you all. So it's not that they were hiding this. I just don't think they even lost the money.
We need to ratify it now. I think we need to ratify it as time sensitive.
How do we do it? Just make it a motion to ratify the amendment?
Just motion to ratify is all that you need to do. Motion to ratify the amendment to the IGA between Forsyth County and Forsyth County Sheriff, but candidly, board members, even the heading there, it's Forsyth County as well. There's a third party that's not captured in the header of the amendment.
And I think that we need to make it time sensitive to make sure that we don't have that exposure. But
we're going to word it too about making it. We need to warn.
Yeah. I make a motion that we ratify the amendment to the intergovernmental agreement between Forsyth County School District, Office of the Forsyth County Sheriff, and the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners as it relates to the SROs. Adding that we also put the school system and sheriff's office on notice that the board.
Not ratify.
We won't ratify future agreements.
Unless we're included in
the board needs to be, you know, however you want to word it. Ken, you know what we're getting at.
Yes.
They need to notify us before they do things, not after.
Yes.
Second. We have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Not, please go to the motion. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. There are none. That motion passes unanimously. We're on to item number 5, county attorney.
Chairman, same issue. This is the other shoe that needs to drop. This is a brand new IGA that we are not a party to, never have been a party to. But the paragraph is actually the enumerated paragraph. Each party agrees with being the sheriff to the extent any allowed by law to indemnify and hold harmless the other parties for any claims or cause of action arising out of the performance of the agreement. Again, my singular concern is if there is, in fact, a claim or controversy arising out of the performance of the agreement, that the Board of Education had the right to seek indemnity from the sheriff, that ultimately that responsibility would fall.
Thank you.
I would make a motion, Mr. Chairman, that we ratify the license, the intergovernmental agreement between the Forsyth County School District and Office of the Sheriff for the license and permission on to use school Board of Education property for mounted patrol with the same language that we put them on notice.
Time sensitive.
And it's time sensitive.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? None, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, like sign. There are none. That motion passes unanimously.